I figured it out. Voice of reason, the solid, hold it down, the beige rage, and the agitator.
The Breakfast Club.
Everyone just kept telling me to prep for this.
One word to describe the Breakfast Club would be black.
Impacting the culture.
People watch the Breakfast Club for like news and really be tuned in, man.
I don't even know what to call this Breakfast Club. It's like brunch.
Envy, Ye, and Charlamagne.
Wake that ass up, get out of bed, and listen to the Breakfast Club.
I'm waking up.
Good morning, USA.
Yo, 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 yo.
Good morning, Angela Yee.
Good morning, DJ MV.
Charlamagne the God.
Peace to the planet. It's Tuesday.
Yes, it's Tuesday.
It is Tuesday. What's happening? How y'all feel out there?
I feel good. How y'all feeling?
I am blessed, black, and highly favored, man. Happy to be alive.
You and me both.
Gratitude is always my attitude.
Oh, man.
I woke up this morning. I didn't just thank God for another day of life. I thank God for my life.
Mm.
Period. In all of its totality.
Yeah.
Yes.
I do that every morning. Thank God for my life, my family's life, our health.
Me.
What you looking for, man?
My slide? Oh, here they go.
Oh. Yeah, so, you know, let me just shout out to everybody again. I know every day I come in here and I'm so grateful and thankful for the support that you guys have showed me and my wife's book. It is really just...
Y'all did the Daily Show last
amazing.
Night,
yeah,
right?
We did the Daily Show with Trevor Noah. But let me just tell you, I'm not in the book world. I'm not a big bookie. As far as reading.
What the hell is a bookie?
Yeah,
bookie
that's like somebody that takes bets.
That's a goddamn gambler.
No, I just made it up. But I'm not a big reader, so the fact that, you know, the book company comes... I'm not a big reader.
But you should start reading more.
I really don't have time. I'm going to start getting into Audible.
Oh,
the
Audible books. I love reading
and I love Audible. But when you're on flights, when you're doing things like that...
Because I don't sleep. I'm always running, so that when I get on the flights, I usually sleep. But I'm going to get into Audible when I'm driving into work. But the book is doing so great. I mean, I am so happy. So it's so ecstatic. And it's just... I just want to say thank you to everybody that purchased the book, that left reviews... Whether you like it or you don't, I just want to say thank you, man. The support is just overwhelming. I mean, you know, in the book world, they have a list. It's the top 100 books, the books that
on Amazon
that people purchase and people download and all that. And the fact that we've been in that top 100 for the last 7 days is amazing. So
that means you're moving some units.
Yeah, and that list is with kids' books, like, so it's your doctor's
millions of books all around the world.
Yeah, 48 Laws of Power, those types of books, 5 Love Languages. So the fact that we're in that thing for the last 7 days is just amazing.
I like what you and Gia are doing. I think it's cute. That's the best way I can describe it. It is. When I see y'all on TV, I'm like, oh, they're so cute together.
That's just all you guys.
No, I'm serious,
cute.
Man. It's something about it. It's something about, you know, being with
cute.
That person that you love from day one. Y'all have grown. Y'all built this family. Y'all telling y'all story. Now y'all out and about, you know, on a press run together. I think that's fly.
But not only that, we're helping a lot of people and helping a lot of couples and helping a lot of relationships, and that's the most important thing. So when I get those DMs and those texts and I see those comments that we're helping
that's
people,
right.
That's the main reason why we did.
Because everybody deserves a nut. An orgasm. I'm sorry. Everybody deserves an orgasm. And you don't got to dump that, Red. I'll take the L for that. Everybody deserves an orgasm.
I agree.
Okay?
I agree.
And I'm happy that y'all out here doing that, amongst other things. It's a lot in the book.
Yeah, it's a lot
other
in the
than
book.
That
so people are getting to it.
But, hey, say what you want. You got to bleed on them pages like that in that way. You have to be that vulnerable to make people care about your book.
And it's the honest truth. And people can learn something from a little bit of the book, whether it's the orgasm part or the insecurity part or the...
If you're not willing to do that, there's no need to write a book. Right.
Correct.
Now, I am listening to Viola Davis, Finding Me.
Oh, I'm reading that.
And from the very beginning, she's bleeding on those pages.
Yes. Yep.
From the very beginning. And if you're not willing to do that, there's no need to write
a book.
Plus
that Oprah interview she did on Netflix. Amazing.
Yeah, you got to be transparent.
You have to be.
Well, let's get the show cracking. Front page news, what are we talking about?
All right. Well, Elon Musk. That's it. That's what we're talking about.
All right. Well, we'll get to that next. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning. Morning, everybody. It's DJ Envy, Angela Yee, Charlamagne Tha God. We are The Breakfast Club. Let's get in some front page news. Now, the Celtics eliminated the Nets last night, 116-112.
I told y'all that was going to happen.
That was a great game, by the way.
No, it wasn't.
Yes,
I didn't think
it was. I was watching it. It was a great game.
No,
at the end, the way that they came back when they were down by so much.
Stop.
Nobody thought that could happen. I thought it was very exciting. Nobody thought they were going to come back and score as much as they did toward the end.
The Nets were very disappointed.
Yeah, they
came
back and they were within 3 points.
First of all, I told y'all they was going to lose this series. Anybody that actually watches basketball knows that that was a terrible mismatch for the Nets, because everything that the Celtics do great, the Nets do horrible. The Nets' defense sucks. They have no team chemistry, and they're simply a terribly coached team. Steve Nash should be up out of there.
Well, I enjoyed watching the game last night. Shout out to my Brooklyn Nets.
The Celtics do all three of those things great. And, you know, I don't like to say things like, you know, somebody's not Batman, they're Robin. And the reason I don't like to say that is simply because Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving are both better than Robin. But I will say, just because Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving are the strongest Avengers, don't mean that they're leaders.
Well, let's hear from Kyrie Irving.
Why do you think the Nets lost the series overall?
Just us gelling as a team. You know, having a lineup out there that, you know, can match up well with them, you know, stopping them from getting offensive rebounds and just being, you know, prepared in a way that, you know, there was a lot of thinking going on out there and you could tell. And, you know, when that's happening, you're not playing with your instincts and the trust in the game. You know, I don't want to say you turn into a shell of yourself, but it's just you're not having the game that you want. You're not playing in the flow and rhythm. And I give credit to the Celtics for making it tough on the defensive end, but majority of it on our end was you know, just trying to find a balance of who's out there with us.
And here's what he had to say as far as whether or not he's staying with the Brooklyn Nets.
In terms of my extension, man, I don't really plan on going anywhere. So this is, like I said, this is added motivation for our franchise to be at the top of the league for the next few years. And, you know, I'm just looking forward to the summer and just building with our guys here.
Well, you know, it's his fault that they haven't gelled. You know, he made a choice, and I respect his choice, but these are the consequences of his choice. When you're not out there with your team can't gel.
Yeah, it was very disappointing. Now, what happens with Ben Simmons? Does the Brooklyn Nets try to trade Ben Simmons?
They have no choice but to bring everybody
back.
Well,
here's what Kyrie had to say.
Well, again, I think it was just really heavy emotionally this season. We all felt it. I felt like I was letting the team down at a point where I wasn't able to play, but I never wanted to just be about me. And I think it became a distraction at times. And, you know, we lost a franchise player and we got a franchise player back, but, you know, we didn't get a chance to see him on the floor. And there was no pressure for him either to step on the floor with us either. You know what I mean? Like, Ben's good. We have his back. He's going to be good for next year.
They need a better coach. Steve Nash got to go. That black man coach, Udoka, who coached the Celtics so well, he should have been their coach, especially being that he was the assistant for the Nets last year. But then he left to go to Boston. And they need a leader. They don't have any leaders. Like Kyrie and Kevin Durant, they don't seem like leaders at all. They're two of the strongest Avengers. They might be Thor and Incredible Hulk, but they're not leaders like Captain America and Tony Stark.
Well, I know a great coach that I think can coach those Brooklyn Nets well. He's from New York. He's from Queens, New York. He used to coach the Golden State Warriors. He actually put that team together before they fired him. I'm talking about Mark Jackson.
Yeah, I don't know why Mark Jackson hasn't had another coaching job in the league. They say it's because of his religious beliefs, but I mean, Lord have mercy. If it was because of his religious beliefs, God would have got him another job, right? I'm just saying.
Shut up, man.
Like that would be kind of bothering me if I was Mark Jackson. Everybody keeps saying it's my religious beliefs. I'm like, well, damn, God, what's up?
Yeah, so shout out to Mark Jackson. I think Mark Jackson, this should give Mark Jackson a shot. Now, the Raptors beat the 76ers 103-88, and the Jazz beat the Mavericks 77-102. I'm sure we'll talk about Elon Musk next hour.
But how does Steve Nash keep escaping all this smoke? Serious question. What is it?
Because I hear a lot of people saying that they think he's a terrible coach.
They just started that in the last 48 hours. I've been saying this for two seasons.
I've been hearing people say that.
The man has no game plan whatsoever. It's run isolation for Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving. Can't make no adjustments on defense.
No plays.
It's like, what are you doing?
Mark Jackson, get up, man.
How do you still have a job? He should have gotten fired last year. And Coach Udoka, who left to go to the Celtics, should have been the next head coach this year.
All right. Well, get it off your chest. 800-585-1051. If you need to vent, phone lines are wide open again. 800-585-1051. Call us up right now. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning.
The Breakfast Club.
Wake up.
Wake your ass.
This is your time to get it off your chest. Whether you're mad or blessed, we want to hear from you on The Breakfast Club.
Hello, who's this?
This is John Marston from Houston on Soft Homicides. How you guys doing this morning?
Peace, John.
John from H-Town. What's up? Get it off your chest.
Well, we've been feeding homeless for the past 4 years, and this season coming up on May 29th, we're also giving the homeless pillows. So I would like for the community to help us donate to help sponsor pillows for us. We feed about 340 homeless every month downtown Houston on Sundays. And I would like for people to help us this year about getting pillows to give to the homeless, because people forget about our family in the streets that are homeless, that's going through mental health, illness, and they need help in the community. So I'm trying to see if you guys could please help us out.
What you
That'd
need,
be a good
brother?
Initiative for you, too. Envy, since you got your car show in Houston.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And I was just thinking about that, yeah.
Where do we donate, brother?
My son's birthday is June 19th. He was murdered. I want to see if I could get a couple of tickets to that car show also, if it's possible.
Absolutely. Done. Car show is June 19th, so come on out. And then, you know, how can we donate and help for you, help you pay for some of them pillows and stuff like that?
Well, the Cash App is $HUH95.
Hold on,
or
hold
you can
on.
Go to
talking too fast. Go ahead, say it again.
$HUH95.
HUH95. All right. And what's the organization, sir?
Houston Unsolved Homicides.
Okay.
Oh, you've called up here before.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
My son's birthday is June 19th, and that's a special day for us. He was murdered to be 5 years in December of this year, and I would love to meet you, Andy, for the first time.
Yeah, absolutely. Possible. Bring the whole family. I'll bring everybody out. Absolutely. The show is June 19th, and we'll give you VIP passes so you can get in there early and all that stuff. So, yeah, absolutely. Stay on the line, and I'll get you information.
One more question, John. Is this a tax-deductible donation?
Not if it's going to Cash
App. Yes, it is. We have 501c3.
So if it goes to Cash App, are y'all going to send me something? Y'all don't have a website?
I'll send you a receipt. Yes, it's www.HoustonUnsolvedHomicides.org.
Yeah, I'll do that. HoustonUnsolvedHomicides.org.
Homicide.
All right, yes. Brother.
And my last name is Marsden, M-A-R-S-D-E-N. So it's also my Facebook page, John Marsden.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Well, you hold on the line so I can get your information and get you those tickets, okay?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
All right. And that's right. June 19th is my car show in Houston, Texas. I'm super duper excited about that. Hello, who's this?
This is Ariel from South Carolina.
Ariel
from South Carolina. What part of South Carolina?
I'm from Pinewood.
Pinewood? What the hell is Pinewood at?
That's part of something.
Oh, okay. Okay. Ja Morant country.
Yes, that's right.
All right.
Well, get it off your chest, mama.
It's my birthday today. I just turned 25.
Happy birthday.
Happy born day, queen.
Thank you. Can I give out my Cash App?
Sure. It's your birthday. Go for it.
Okay. It's $AROLEWASH91.
I'm gonna send you $15 so you can go to Waffle House this morning.
There
maybe,
you go.
Maybe IHOP.
Thank you, Charlamagne. Thank you.
Oh, what's the Cash App again?
It's $AROLEWASH91. Okay, let me do it over.
He's gonna send it to somebody else.
Yeah, you gotta make sure you get it right. Get it right.
Right. It's AROLEWASH91.
91.
Ariel Wash 91.
All right, mama.
Thank you.
Hot $20 right now.
There you go.
Oh, thank you, Charlamagne.
Yes, ma'am.
Get it off your chest. 800-585-1051. If you need to vent, hit us up now. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning.
The Breakfast Club. Your time to get it off your chest, whether you're mad or blessed.
So you better have the same energy.
We want to hear from you on The Breakfast Club.
Hello, who's this?
Hey, how you doing? This is Lo.
Hey, Lo. Good morning. Get it off your chest.
All right. So, first of all, I want to say, BJ and B, I appreciate you and your wife, Brooke. We appreciate you as well as Charlamagne. However, I just want to know, if your husband's been cheated multiple times, I'm talking about over 25 times,
oof,
and at this point, your book is just about one cheating, would you still recommend your book to be read by him?
I mean, I recommend that
you got to read it 25 times.
You stupid.
Now, buy 25 copies.
I recommend you definitely read the book. There's so many different things than just me talking about cheating in the book, but I definitely would recommend the book. And as far as forgiveness is concerned, that's on case to case. You have to decide if that's what you want to do, if he's willing to do the work, or if you're willing to stay. I mean, everything
so
is different.
If you forgave him? What if you forgave him so much that he overloves you now? So would you still say that book is for us?
Overloves you? What do you mean overloves you?
I mean, I think that book could be for any couple.
As far as when I say overlove, he doesn't believe that his love is accepted. He believes that, okay, well, now I'm the good guy, you're the bad person.
Well,
that's part. Well, yeah, you should definitely get the book then, because that we have a topic, a chapter on that called Mind F***, and that's what he's doing right now. The whole thing is you're hurt. You're the one that's been hurt, not him. So he has to understand that, and he should be doing right and allow you to heal, and he has to heal himself. But the fact that he's making it seem like you're the bad guy, we have a chapter in that book called Mind F***, and that's what he's trying to do to you.
Yeah, because, I mean, we all know the best apology is change behavior, right?
Correct.
If he ain't changing, he ain't apologized. But
no, he changed 100%. I can give him that. However, I just can't give him the fact that I'm still trying to heal, and I'm still trying to find myself, and I'm still trying to love you and accept your love, but you're not believing.
And he has to accept what that. He can't just wait and say, okay, well, I apologize. Now, what else do you want from me? Blood. No, it doesn't work like that.
What does Gia say? Gia says, Until,
right? And that's the thing.
Until
she's healed, until you're healed, until you feel like you want to give him full forgiveness, and he has to sit in that. And if he doesn't want to sit in that, then maybe it might be time to let him go. But you have to heal, and he can't tell you when you heal. It doesn't take a day. It doesn't take a month. It took Gia years to heal.
If I got caught cheating 25 times, I don't even think I would even ask to be forgiven. I'd be like, hey, man, you got me, man. Lock me up. Send me away. 25 times with the same person or different people?
Multiple.
But God
it's
damn.
It's not even about that, because it's like, I knew that this was, you know, the girls went after him because of his reputation, whatever, but it doesn't matter. But Charlamagne, as far as for you, I know that I need to see therapy because you changed 100%. Like, I used to hate to hear your voice in the morning because you always said something negative. Now you became into this positive person, and that's what I want for myself.
Why are you staying?
Oh, because I know he could change. I know he was way stronger than what he was portraying in the street when he was living the street life.
Mm-hmm.
It's so much. Like, he's a gentleman. He's a great father, and it's not about the kids. I've been with him since I was 13.
Okay.
I knew he could change. I knew he had more inside of him.
Well, let's do this. I'm gonna send you the book. I'm gonna send you the book right now, all right? And I guarantee you that this book will help you and your husband. We are very transparent in the book, and we talk about all the games that I played in that relationship. And one of those is, it seems like that you're dealing with it right now. So I will send you the book, and I beg that you and your husband read it together.
And I beg that y'all go to therapy, too.
And definitely go to therapy.
Y'all need couples counseling.
We also had some help in some therapy. Wasn't necessarily a therapist, but we definitely had some counseling. And I think that, you know, I think that it'll help you significantly, Mama.
Okay.
All right, you hold, you stay on the line.
And get somebody to come over and smudge your husband's penis.
What?
Okay. All of that.
No, he doesn't need that.
All right.
Hold on, okay?
25 people?
Okay.
Don't hang up.
25 people is a lot of energy, bro. That's a lot. Because energy is never lost or destroyed. It's merely transferred from one party to the next. 25 people is a lot of people to be sharing energy with.
Get it off your chest. 800-585-1051. If you need to vent, you can hit us up. Now we got rumors on the way.
Yes, and Viola Davis, she is responding to people who are critical of her portrayal of Michelle Obama. We'll tell you what she had to say regarding that U.S. TV drama series, The First Lady.
All right, we'll get into that next. Don't move. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning.
The Breakfast Club.
It's about time.
What's going on?
This is the Rumor Report.
Talk to him.
With Angela Yee on The Breakfast Club.
All right, well, Chris Brown and Little Baby are going on tour together. It's the One of Them Ones North American Tour. It's the Rolling Loud Presented Tour that kicks off in Raleigh, North Carolina on July 15th. So if you want to go see the two of them together, a lot of stops. They're going to be in Boston, Newark, Hartford, Connecticut, Toronto, Indianapolis, Chicago, Cincinnati, Detroit, amongst other places. Atlanta, of course.
That sounds like it's going to be dope.
Yeah, and the Sixers better hope this tour starts after the playoffs. If not, they're in trouble. Okay, because Harden going to be making some choices.
Oh, shut up, man.
James Harden going to be making some decisions. Player go to the tour, Lil Baby
well,
and Chris
it kicks
Brown.
Off July 15th.
I mean, that is the finals be going on then? Yeah. It should be over by then, right?
It'd be over by then.
Yeah. Ooh.
All right, now.
Shut up, man.
You dodged the bullet, Sixers.
Bad Bunny has been cast as El Muerto in the first live-action Marvel movie with a Latino lead, so congratulations to him. That news was announced yesterday during CinemaCon's Sony panel at the Forum at Caesar's Palace, and Bad Bunny was there himself also. He said, this opportunity to bring El Muerto to life, it's amazing. It's incredible. I love wrestling. I grew up watching wrestling, and now I'm a wrestler. I think it's the perfect role for me. It will be epic. And that will be in theaters. This is way in advance. January 12th, 2024.
I wonder if his little stint in the WWE, I don't want to say little, that was disrespectful. I wonder if his stint in the WWE got him that role.
Yeah, he debuted last year in WWE, and people really praised his performance.
Now, he killed it in WWE. Mm-hmm. You could tell he really practiced. He went through the routine. He killed it.
All right. Now, Viola Davis has responded to people who have been critical of her portrayal of Michelle Obama in the new U.S. TV drama series, The First Lady. People said that she was overly pursing her lips, and a lot of people were complaining that her facial expressions were distracting and insulting. Here is a snippet of her playing Michelle Obama.
Really? John Edwards have Secret Service? What about John McCain, Mitt Romney?
Probably not.
Yeah. You know why? You're a coon. You're a running for president of the United States.
Now, she spoke to BBC News, and she said it is incredibly hurtful when people say negative things about your work. And she said criticism is an occupational hazard of acting, and you know, how do you move on from the hurt, from failure? But you have to. Not everything is going to be an awards-worthy performance.
Hey, man, this is just proof that anybody can get it. Because it's wild that y'all not giving Viola Davis any grace. Lord have mercy. I see people slandering Viola Davis all the time about this role. And I'm like, damn, that's Viola Davis. Viola Davis can't get no grace? Jesus.
All right, now Lala Anthony is going to be hosting Vogue magazine's Met Gala live stream, so congratulations to her. She wrote on Instagram, the secret is out. The biggest night in fashion, the Met Gala, returns on Monday, May 2nd, and I'm hosting Vogue's official Met Gala live stream, so congratulations. She'll be there with Hamish Bowles and Vanessa Hudgens.
Oh, that's next week, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yep. My God. You know what that means?
What?
Dr. Strange comes out on May 5th. Next Friday, baby.
What the hell is Doctor
Strange Part 2 in the Multiverse of Madness? May is here. Let's go.
What in the kiddie comics are you talking about?
You stay in the child's place.
All right. Well, the theme this year, because, you know, there's a theme every year, is In America, an Anthology of Fashion. It's a continuation of 2021's In America, a Lexicon of Fashion theme.
What does that mean?
Every year, I don't know how you're supposed to interpret that and dress accordingly.
Interpret that.
It's when you put on something that you'll never wear again and you would never wear anyplace else other than the Met Gala or a Halloween party.
Absolutely.
Okay.
All right. Now, Kylie Jenner has testified that she and Tyga warned Rob Kardashian about Black China's history of violence. Tyga had shown Kylie Jenner a scar he said was from China cutting him with a knife. Rob Kardashian told his sister that he was going to continue seeing her anyway. This was Kylie Jenner in L.A. telling the jury that she and Tyga visited Rob Kardashian just to let him know about those things. And she said, I was a little concerned based on things I heard about China from Tyga. She felt it was her duty to express what we knew. But she said Rob was going to do what he was going to do anyway. As we told you, Black China is suing the Kardashian Jenners for $100 million, saying that Kris Jenner rallied her daughters in a smear campaign that cost her tens of millions of dollars in future income. So we'll keep you updated on what's going on in the courtroom. All right, I'm Angela Yee, and that is your rumor report.
All right, thank you, Miss Yee. Now we got front page news next. What are we talking about?
Elon Musk.
You said that earlier, and we ain't talking about it.
I told you we weren't going to get to it.
All right, we'll talk about it next. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning.
The Breakfast Club. Your mornings will never be the same.
Peace to the planet. This is Charlamagne Tha God, and it's NFT Tuesday, and the second Breakfast Club NFT collection is almost ready to drop. Drop one sold out. Drop two is going to be even better, so don't wait. Head over to oneof.com for more info on The Breakfast Club NFT.
Morning, everybody. It's DJ Envy, Angela Yee, Charlamagne Tha God. We are The Breakfast Club. Let's get in some front page news. Now, last night, the Raptors beat the 76ers 103-88. The Mavericks beat the Jazz 102-77. And the Celtics eliminated the Nets 116-112.
I told y'all the Celtics was going to win that series. The Nets have great players, but they're not a great team.
You did.
Steve Nash is terrible as a coach, and I'm glad folks are finally starting to say it because he needs to go. The Nets have no identity. They don't play defense. They have zero chemistry, and they have no real leadership.
I'm just saying, Mark Jackson's out here just chilling. You can definitely call Mark Jackson. He's a great coach. You see what he did for the Golden State Warriors.
I agree.
I think you should give Mark Jackson a try. And he's from New York, so he doesn't care about the necessary to press. I mean, Mark Jackson's the guy.
And people keep talking about they don't want to hire Mark Jackson because of his religious beliefs. clearly God doesn't feel that way. Because if he was supposed to have a job, he'd have one. So clearly God isn't in this situation like y'all think he is.
I hate you.
Okay?
What else we got, Easy?
All right, well, Elon Musk is going to be buying Twitter. It's a $44 billion deal. Twitter said Monday they have agreed to sell, and that has the potential to expand his business empire and put the world's richest man in charge of Twitter.
Is that a good investment? Do people people on Twitter like that now? Or is Twitter slowing down a little bit? It seems like it's slowing down a little bit.
It's like 300 million users on Twitter. Instagram has more. Facebook definitely has more. But people feel like Twitter is where the conversations start. Matter of fact, I read an article once that said 70% of all breaking news happens on Twitter.
Now, Elon Musk himself is a high-profile Twitter user. He has more than 83 million followers on that platform. And he's used that platform for years, sharing memes, discussing his companies, insulting politicians. He did spread some misleading claims about COVID. A lot of different things has happened for him on Twitter. And he said he wants to make Twitter better than ever by enhancing the product with new features, making the algorithms open source to increase trust, defeating the spam bots, and authenticating all humans. And he said in a tweet, of course, that he hopes that even his worst critics remain on Twitter because that is what free speech means.
Now, I see people up in arms about this, acting like it's the end of the world. Is this really a threat? Are people upset that a billionaire is just doing what billionaires do?
I think, everything is kind of up in the air. They don't know what's going to happen moving forward. Some people think it's a great thing.
No.
Some people think it's a terrible thing. Twitter co-founder Jack Dorsey has endorsed Elon Musk's vision for the platform.
He said
Elon's goal of creating a platform that is maximally trusted and broadly inclusive is the right one. And so some people feel like that's what we need, a platform where people can express themselves freely.
Yeah, I don't like that, though.
Tell me why.
Free speech is great, right? But the problem with it is when people lie, right? And people could throw out these lies and
misinformation.
And misinformation, and the fact that there's no policing on it, people will believe it. And I think that's very dangerous.
But there's no policing on any of these sites.
Yeah, well,
No, there's not.
Yes,
there's no policing on any of these sites.
If somebody's
all of these sites spread misinformation.
Or somebody's putting misinformation, you can
file a
report.
And sometimes a lot of people get banned.
People get thrown into Twitter jail, and there's some trigger words that's on there that they'll make them flag you, and then your account can get taken down, as we've seen on Instagram.
From
many people who have gotten their accounts taken away.
Because his rhetoric was dangerous.
Right, but if...
Yeah, so there is some sort of policing.
If they don't allow, if there's no policing, he's still going to be on
this. But that's the president of the United States of America. His profile was extremely high. 95% of the people on social media are doing exactly what Trump does every single day to folks. Mm-hmm. And they don't get that type of backlash because they're not the president.
Right. Some of them do. I think when they found, some of them definitely do get banned and get taken down.
Yeah. Actually, Twitter just recently banned some misleading climate change posts as well. So that just happened a couple of days ago.
But how is that Elon Musk's fault, though?
Denying climate change. Mm-hmm. Nobody said it's his fault.
Oh, I'm saying, because even with him buying Twitter, he
hasn't bought it yet. It still all has to get approved. So.
But he can't stop that. Like, how do you stop that?
Well, I think he's saying he's taking that away. He's taking away any type of policing.
Well, no, I don't know about that, because they are still going to make sure that you can't just put up, like, false, misleading information. So I don't know that he's going to not ban anything, because he does also want to get rid of the bots. But I think he wants people to be able to express themselves freely. Like, what's the balance here?
Now, by the way, that's something that he said that I agree with. He said he wants to get rid of the bots because he wants to know who's really human. And if you look at some of these situations, like I was looking at the Amber Heard, Johnny Depp case, they said that 11% mm-hmm. of the tweets that were coming out in defense of Amber Heard were fake. Mm. So they were bots. So it's just like people hire these campaigns sometimes on social media to slander people. And it's just like, yo, yeah, get rid of that.
Mm-hmm. All right.
They do that to slander people. They do that to, you know, spread misinformation, to sway elections. Yes, yeah. Get rid of that. Get rid of the bots and everything else.
But that's policing it. That's policing Twitter.
I'm with that.
Which I think we need.
If it's real humans with real opinions and they're not dangerous, causing people to actually get killed and hurt, fine. But, you know, at some point, we got to have some discretion, too, as human beings, right?
Mm-hmm.
And realize that some of this stuff just simply ain't the truth. Everything you see on social media is not the truth.
All right, well... That is your front page news. Let's open up the phone lines. Let's have a conversation about this, all right? 800-585-1051. Now, Elon Musk, the owner and founder of Tesla, is purchasing Twitter for how much?
$44 billion.
$44 billion. Now, some of the things that he wants to do is what on Twitter, Yee?
Well, what he says is that he wants to make sure free speech is there, the bedrock of a functioning democracy. He said Twitter is the digital town square where matters vital to the future of humanity are debated. I also want to make Twitter better than ever by enhancing the product with new features, making the algorithms open source to increase trust, defeating the spam bots, and authenticating all humans. Twitter has tremendous potential.
And I hope he said he might make it subscription-based. I hope he does that.
And he said he wants his worst critics to remain on Twitter because that is what free speech means.
All right. Well, let's talk about it. Let's open up the phone lines again. 800-585-1051. What are your thoughts? Now, I like subscription-based.
I do, too. I want you to pay for that free speech.
I'm going to tell you why. Yeah, because one, I don't think a bot's going to be able to pay for it. You know, and then you could find out where that money's coming from.
And it's going to make other people think about, do I really need to be on here?
Correct.
Do I really need to be on here all day tweeting and slandering people?
800-585-1051. Let's talk about it. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning.
The Breakfast Club.
It's topic time. Pick up the phone, baby. Call 800-585-1051 to join into the discussion with The Breakfast Club.
Talk about it.
Morning, everybody. It's DJ Envy, Angela Yee, Charlamagne Tha God. We are The Breakfast Club. Now, if you just joined us, we're talking about Elon Musk purchasing Twitter for what, $44 billion?
Yes, $44 billion.
All right. Now, people are talking about, now, what's he saying about the platform and what he wants to do?
Well, basically, he wants to get rid of all of those bots, but he also wants to make sure that there's free speech and that people can say what they need to say, be critical of what they want to be critical of, even of himself, and that they have the platform to do it.
I believe that, but I feel like if people are lying, if people are spreading false information, they should be blocked and banned off of the platform. Like, just think about the guy that started the rumor just because that ASAP Rocky and Rihanna, that they were breaking up and that he cheated on and then said, okay, I apologize, I'm sorry, I just created that. Could you imagine what that did to every party involved? That's not right. You just free speech, you just can't say, I'm going to say what I want to say just because.
I agree, but is that worthy of a ban?
Yes.
Donald Trump is banned
from social media?
And yes. And Donald Trump said platforms. Even if his ban gets lifted, he said he still won't go back to Twitter.
He blatantly just made up a lie just to hurt people. Like, yes, if you do it once,
Well, I'm not defending that guy at all because I agree with you to a certain extent, but he said he got that information from somebody. That's what he said.
Oh.
You know what I mean?
And there's certain things he wants to do, like have an edit button on Twitter, which I think is a good thing. I hate that once you do a tweet, if you mess up something, you got to delete the whole tweet and start over.
I'm going to be honest with you. I personally don't care that Elon Musk bought Twitter. I'm not an active Twitter user at all. I used to be, but I haven't been on there for about 3 or 4 years now, so I personally don't care. Folks are acting like this is about to be the end of the world. I don't know if this is a reason to really ring the alarm or people just mad that billionaires are billionaires. You know what I'm saying? Because people think these billionaires have too much money, too much power, too much influence now. They've been trying to break up big tech. I think Jeff Bezos owns,
one of the magazines.
One of those big newspapers. I can't remember which one it is. Now, you know, Elon Musk has control of Twitter. So they think these billionaires have too much money, too much power, too much influence.
Well, yeah, they think it's because Twitter is influential as a media platform that him having control of that will be him controlling the media. And, you know, he's used it to control stocks and crypto and all of that.
I just don't see how that's possible, because if he does start, let's just say, blocking people he doesn't agree with, they'll just go to another platform.
Right.
But you know what I'm saying?
But Twitter used to be, remember when Twitter first started, it was fun. It was a way to have fun and talk to people, and then it just turned.
Boy, that was all right. It was too much fun. We had too much fun. That's why so many of us get in trouble over old tweets now.
Because truthfully, this will be great for Elon Musk, for his businesses and his companies. You know, that's, I think, another fear that people have, that you can manipulate the news and then that can help, like, stock prices go up and things like that.
But he's already got multi-millions of followers.
He's got 83 million followers.
Yeah, he could do that with a tweet now. Like, he doesn't have to own Twitter to have that that influence.
He just spent $44 billion. I don't think he cares about the stock price.
That's why he's rich, though.
Hello, who's this?
This is Nicole from Ohio.
Nicole from Ohio. Good morning. Talk to us, Nicole.
Hi. Good morning to you, the Breakfast Club.
Good morning, Nicole.
Good morning.
Good morning. I think that Elon Musk purchasing Twitter is a bad idea. I don't think there's going to be any policing at all, meaning, as Angela Yee stated, how sometimes if people on Instagram or Facebook, if they're saying, giving misinformation or saying something crazy, you know, your account will be taken down. I don't think he's going to do any of that.
Right. Think about how Facebook influenced elections, and they still, people are so still angry about that. You know,
exactly.
But that. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but Mark Zuckerberg was in court. Like, people was holding Mark Zuckerberg accountable. Like, right. You think Elon Musk want that kind of smoke?
I don't think so.
They have to do something.
Hello, who's this?
Hi, DJ Envy. Hi, Auntie Angie. Hi, Uncle Charlotte.
Peace, peace, peace. How are you?
Happy Tuesday. Talk to us. What you think? What's your thoughts?
So I think they're going to use another platform. If they do a subscription for this one and stop all trains on this one, they're just going to use another one.
I agree, because people don't want to pay for stuff, especially when you're used to stuff being free. It's so hard to take that away, unless maybe there's ads on here if it's free, and then without it, there's more you can do if you have to pay. That's the only way I could see if there's like another level, you know, if you pay for it.
Exactly. Uncle Shala, can I please have some books? Please?
I have,
speaking
I
of
have
free.
Anita Kopack, Shallow Waters up here. I'll send you that.
Thank you so much.
Done. I'm going to put you on hold.
Y'all have a good morning. Duval.
800-585-1051. We're talking about Elon Musk purchasing Twitter for $44 billion. What's your thoughts? They're talking free speech. All right. We'll take your calls when we come back at the Breakfast Club. Good morning. I know it now.
Call me.
Add your opinion to the Breakfast Club topic.
Come on.
800-585-1051.
Morning, everybody. It's DJ Envy, Angela Yee, Charlamagne Tha God. We are the Breakfast Club. Good morning. Now, if you're just joining us, we're talking about Elon Musk, you know, the owner of Tesla. He just purchased, well, he's trying to purchase Twitter right now for $44 billion.
He got it.
Yes, so once all of that goes through and everything gets approved, yes. Some people are upset, too, because Twitter's been doing a lot to try, and I don't know if it's enough still, with bullying, harassment, misinformation, so they feel like this will be a step backwards for users.
I don't know why people feel like that, though. Like, because it's impossible to control any of these social media sites. You're dealing with people. People are the most unpredictable things on this planet. You cannot control human behavior. You can police it. But by the time you police it, the damage has probably already been done.
Hello, who's this?
Hey, what's going on, man? This is Trill.
Trill, what's up, brother? Where you calling from?
I'm calling from Jacksonville. I'm not from Jacksonville, though.
Okay.
It means nothing. Once you drink the water there, you are a crazy Duval Floridian, okay?
My goodness.
Nah, not even close. Not even close.
Talk to us. What's your thoughts, brother?
First off, thank you guys for letting me come on and state my opinion.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Angelique. Angela Lee, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm well. Free speech does not mean free from consequences.
That's
so
right.
Elon Musk is, and I'm a vet, and mm-hmm. I firmly support, I put my life on the line for this Constitution. I firmly believe in this nation and its potential. But Elon Musk is clueless. And Charlamagne.
Mm-hmm.
There are instances where people are kicked off these social media sites. You make a lot of comments, bro, that are emotional, but you're a cancer, so.
I didn't say people don't get kicked off these sites. I'm just saying, how do you police it all? You can't police it all.
In the very beginning. I didn't say you can't police it. In the very beginning of the conversation.
What did I say?
You did say people don't get kicked off these sites.
They
you
don't.
Say that, please.
Bro, they do not get kicked off at a high rate, and y'all know that.
Not
like, come on.
Rate.
That's not what you said. You're changing your comment now.
You're changing the goalpost.
Okay, well, let me ask you a question. Let me ask you a simple question. And who's the last person you saw get kicked off that wasn't Donald Trump and Minister Farrakhan?
Well, I don't know if we know all the people.
Well,
could be
so how can y'all make the statement that people get kicked off then?
No, I'm just saying I don't know that we know everyone.
There's a difference between a high-end person and a celebrity that gets kicked off and an average individual.
So who are the average individuals that get kicked off?
Caesar's wife just got kicked off of Instagram and Twitter.
Just because we don't know it doesn't mean it doesn't happen.
So how can y'all make that statement with such confidence?
Envy just said somebody. Why did Jenny Tips get kicked off?
I don't know. I didn't ask, but I know she was kicked off.
And by the way, we know people get put in Twitter jail. We know that.
Now, during a recent TED interview, they asked Elon Musk if there's any limits to his notion of free speech. And he said that Twitter would abide by national laws that restrict speech around the world. Beyond that, he said he would be very reluctant to delete posts or permanently ban users who violate the company's rules. He said, I want it to really have the perception and reality that speech is as free as reasonably possible.
And I'm going to tell you what that could also mean. There's people that's getting kicked off of Instagram and stuff just for using certain language, for referring to themselves as the B word. or for using the, you can't even use the N-word in your captions on Instagram, and sometimes they'll take your account down or take your post down. So that's probably what he's talking about.
Hello, who's this?
This is Chris.
Chris, what's up, bro? Where you calling from?
Calling from Atlanta.
Atlanta, talk to us. What's your thoughts?
I mean, if he's going to do what he say he's going to do, I think it's a good thing. But we got to be careful when we start saying, you know, we can't allow false information on there because people been lying forever.
That's a fact.
It got to be on us to go ahead and do our due diligence, make sure we fact check for ourselves. We can't let people, other people think for us, because then they could just put anything on there and we rely on that to be a factual source. And then next thing you know, they could be lying to us and we just fall for it because we just expect them to be telling the truth all the time and monitoring it.
And even to what the last caller was saying, you know, like, we don't know who's getting taken off social media for what. So there's people on social media right now that's lying their ass off. But because their page isn't being removed, people might just assume that's the truth. And by the way, there's people that get their pages taken down that's telling the absolute truth. So you don't know what's what.
Well, I ain't gonna front. I'm off that Twitter.
I haven't been on Twitter in 3-4 years.
But what I'm about to get
I use
on
my Twitter.
It's so. OnlyFans. Catch Me Outside Girl made $50 million on OnlyFans. What she got? What?
Envy,
what
you don't have to show? You don't have it.
What don't I have?
Mm-mm. I think if you did fake beard tutorials.
Or if you did orgasm classes.
Like show people what to avoid when it comes to drawing your beard on. Because sometimes your beard looks good, sometimes it looks ridiculous.
You know, so you, days should do your, looks, you know who's OnlyFans you should look at, Envy, and you would make a lot of money if you did yours like Bobby Lights.
What does Bobby Light's OnlyFans look like?
You gotta go look and see. If you did something similar to his, I feel like you'd do well.
You know how you could break the fourth wall? What do they call it? The fourth wall? What's Deadpool do? You could break the fourth wall by literally letting people see that artist draw your beard.
Yo,
on.
Shut
Nobody's
up,
doing that.
I think.
I just saw one online yesterday.
You don't think my feet could do it? Like if I put my feet on OnlyFans, I could make like a couple
draw
of
the beard on your feet.
You know.
Now
what?
We talking.
I hate you, man.
Bearded feet.
I hate
Beijing
you.
For feet. King, come on.
You got rumors on the way.
King.
Yes, and
I hate y'all.
And of course, we are going to talk about Megan Thee Stallion, her sit-down interview with Gil King, and we'll tell you some of the highlights of what she had to say about her case against Tory Lanez.
New book, Real Life, Real Beard, all right? Just for you. Just for you. All right, rumors on the way. It's The Breakfast Club. Good
morning. That's a lie. That should be discontinued in Barnes & Noble. We're just spreading false information.
DJ Envy,
classic right
Angela
there.
Yee, Charlamagne the God. We are the Breakfast Club. That's Big Pun Joe. Still hey. Not a player. All right. Good morning to you. Shout out to Tamron Hall and Trevor Noah. Yesterday I was on a Tamron Hall show and I was on Trevor Noah's show as well.
I saw you on there flirting with Trevor.
I was not flirting
you
with Trevor.
You were definitely flirting with Trevor.
You jealous?
You were definitely flirting with Trevor.
Are you jealous?
And Trevor was like, Trevor was like, how are you in bed, Envy? I was like, what? You couldn't wait to tell him.
What? Are you jealous?
Was I jealous of you and Trevor? Let me think. Let me feel into this.
Unpack it.
No, I wasn't.
Why not?
Maybe just a little.
No, there you go.
You know what I'm saying? We do need to have a don't play gay bill because you know what I'm
what?
Saying? No.
What?
Are you
no.
talking about?
Like, you can't, we're not allowed to play gay with other people. Just each other.
Yeah, what
you mean? I'm gonna, you know what? I'm gonna do the don't play gay bill. I'm gonna write it up and I'm gonna have Donnell Rollins notarize it.
Okay.
And we have to make a deal to only play gay with each other. Okay?
This is awkward.
You go on these other little shows and you start flirting with Trevor Noah. I was like, wow. Wow.
So you realize you're not special.
Exactly. That's what I'm talking about, Yee. That's all I'm saying.
My goodness.
Wow.
This is awkward and uncomfortable.
Why is it awkward and uncomfortable?
Well, again, shout out to Trevor Noah and Tamron Hall for having me on their show, right?
Mm-hmm. And you've been turning it up ever since Gia said it turned her on, even though she was playing. But you just, you know, every now and then.
How do you know she was playing?
Because she said it.
I don't know.
I didn't hear her say
that. You've been putting a little extra gay sauce on it ever since she said that, just in case.
A little extra
okay?
gay sauce.
Logan! You also do a video going through the revolving door.
Logan, what the street saying, Logan? Tell me what the street still think me and your pop sus, Logan? Talk to me, Logan.
Yes, he does. He told me that the other day. Oh, my goodness. So let's get to the rumors. What are we talking about?
We'll be talking about Megan Thee Stallion sitting down with Gil King.
All right, we'll
salute
get to
Gail King.
It's the Breakfast Club. Good morning.
It's time.
She's spilling the tea.
This is the Rumor Report with Angela Yee on the Breakfast Club.
Well, Megan Thee Stallion gave her first TV interview on CBS Morning's Gail King, and she shared her version yesterday on how the shooting played out. It was almost 2 years ago. It was in July of 2020 after a pool party at Kylie Jenner's house in Hollywood Hills, and, well, should I say mansion. And she talked about a lot of different things. Here's what she had to say about getting shot.
It was an argument because I was ready to go and everybody else wasn't ready to go. Mm-hmm. But I never put my hands on anybody. And all I hear is this man screaming. He said, dance, bitch. And he started shooting. Like, he shot a couple of times. Mm-hmm. And I was so scared.
So is he in the car, shooting from the car, Megan?
He is standing up over the window, okay, shooting. Mm-hmm. And I didn't even want to move because I'm like, oh my God, if I take the wrong step, I don't know if he can shoot something that's like super important. I don't know if he could shoot me and kill me. Like,
were you afraid for your life at that time?
I was really scared because I had never been shot at before.
Now, Gil King also asked her about Tory Lanez saying that they had relationships, sexual relations, and whether or not they dated. And here's what happened.
What was the nature of
your... We were not dating. We were really close. We were friends. We hung out like every day. And his mom passed too. So when I felt like we were bonding over that. Mm-hmm. And
did you have an intimate relationship with him?
Like sexual?
Yeah, yeah. Did you have a sexual relationship with Tory Lanez? Yes, that's my question.
I didn't have a sexual relationship with Tory.
So why do you think he's putting out the story that the two of you had a relationship and that you're making the whole thing up?
I think that he is trying to deflect from the fact that he committed a crime.
Now, after this night, Megan Thee Stallion also says that Tory Lanez did allegedly apologize and beg her and her, at the time, best friend Kelsey not to say anything.
What is he saying, Tory Lanez saying?
He's apologizing. He's like, I'm so sorry. Please don't tell nobody. I'll give y'all $1 million if y'all don't say nothing. And I'm like, what are you talking about? Like, what are you offering me money right now? Help me. Like, and if you're sorry, just help me. Like,
but at that moment,
we didn't even make it to the house. Like, somebody had already called the police, and it was like so many of them. It was helicopters. I was like, oh my God, we all about to die. Like, it's a hot gun in the car. I'm bleeding. I've been shot. They about to kill somebody. Like, something bad is about to happen.
I could see why somebody would feel like that during that time when a whole bunch of police are around. It's helicopters. Now, she also talked about why she lied and initially said that she stepped on glass.
I didn't want them to kill any of us, mm-hmm, or shoot any of us. Mm-hmm. So I just said, I stepped on glass, mm-hmm, because I didn't
want...
Why
did you say that? Why didn't you say he shot me?
For some reason, I was just trying to protect all of us because I didn't want them to kill us. Like, even though this person just did this to me, mm-hmm, my first reaction still was to try to save us. Like. Mm-hmm. And sometimes I wish I really would have never said that.
You wish you would have just told the truth.
I wish I would have told the truth, but if it saved all of us from dying, then that's just probably what it was meant to be.
Mm-hmm. The worst thing about this whole case, and like most cases, is that it's being tried in the court of public opinion. Like, mm-hmm, we live in a society that loves to play judge, jury, and executioner. Nobody has access to court transcripts, medical records, so all the information is coming from secondhand sources on social media, and it feels like both parties are trying to convince the public as opposed to trying to convince the court.
Now, Meg Thee Stallion also said the doctor did find bullet fragments. Some people were trying to say that there was no bullet fragments, that there was just glass. Mm-hmm.
The police questioned me. And I said it was just glass.
You still stuck with that story?
I stuck with it. It was glass. And right as the officers were like, okay, we done with this, we leaving, the doctor came in and he was like, you know, you got bullets in both of your feet. Like, you got fragments in this foot and it's like right on the back of your Achilles. Mm-hmm. And I'm like...
There is a medical report that says that there were bullet, that you had been shot. Mm-hmm. And the medical report also says that to this day you still have
bullet fragments
in
my feet.
Mm. CBS did review the medical report, which stated that she was shot and that major fragments were removed, but tiny fragments do remain to this day. Now, as far as how this has
medical report
affected her, she talks about her anxiety.
I've got this wall and I don't want to make any friends and I'm trying to be as nice as I can to everybody. New people, I probably don't even hold a conversation longer than 30 minutes because I feel like every time I'm talking, I'm like on the verge of tears and I don't want to have to explain to strangers why I'm crying.
Yeah.
Half the time I just want to pick up the phone and call my mama and be like, what do I do? Like, it's too much. And I feel like I have to hold it in because I have to be strong for so many people.
Oh, Megan. Now, I want to skip ahead to Gil King, because after doing the interview, Gil King actually spoke about doing this interview and why Megan Thee Stallion is speaking out. Because some people are like, why is she doing interviews?
It's very intense and very candid. Keep in mind, guys, this happened 2 years ago, and it still creates a lot of emotion. And I think when something like this happens to you, she claims that she was shot. There's video evidence. She still has bullet. We have the medical report. She still has bullet fragments in her feet even today.
Oh my.
And the fact that she still sometimes gets dragged online, I think it just got to her. And she wanted to put out her own narrative. And I think that's why she's finally speaking for the very first time. But as you see, it's still extremely, extremely painful for her.
Oh, and she's also doing interviews because Tori was talking. I mean, it's also that simple.
And well, also, I think social media, people on social media are attacking her. And she wants to put out what happened by her account so that way people can understand and stop attacking
her. But social media is attacking her based off what
Tori said.
Tori said.
And here's what Gil King says her hope for Meg Thee Stallion is.
Is the inspiration for speaking out now? Is it closure?
I really do think, Suzanne, she had just had it with people telling her story and that she not speaking out in her own narrative. My hope is that she will resist the urge to go online and see what people are saying. Because you guys know this, you can go down a very dark hole and you can't get out of it. Mm-hmm. And you can get 100 great comments and you get a couple of cranky Yankees. And that's what you focus on. That's what tears you up. And I hope that she resists that urge. I'm hoping that after this airs, she will feel stronger, she will feel lighter, and she will feel, look, I told my story, and now whether you believe me or not, at least I know the truth. The people that care and support her know the truth.
I agree with Gayle King about those cranky Yankees.
Yeah, I don't like cranky Yankees.
Those cranky Yankees. And salute to Gayle King. She did a great job letting Megan tell her story. I just think that it came off like Megan was trying to convince us that she's telling the truth. And the only place she should be doing that is in the court of law, not the court of public opinion. Like, let the evidence speak for itself when that time comes. They just got to let everything play out in court.
But I understand why what Gil King had to say, that she hopes she does feel lighter about things.
Oh, of course.
And Tory Lanez, in the meantime, is pleading not guilty. He's facing one felony count each of assault with a semi-automatic firearm and carrying a loaded unregistered firearm in a vehicle. He is out on bail right now and facing a maximum sentence of 22 years and 8 months in state prison. And his attorney told CBS Mornings, "We look forward to addressing Ms. Pete's claims, including all its consistencies, discrepancies, and omissions in a court of law."
They pick a jury from that, though,
and that's the problem, because it's playing out so publicly,
right? Yeah, because how do you pick a jury?
They gotta be swayed.
You're not supposed to be able to hear something. Is you supposed to be just you know? So how do you pick the jury? And then if you do, it's not going to be a jury of your peers, right? Because anybody in our world heard it, both sides.
All right.
And it's like, you know, I think I said yesterday that, you know, Megan seemed defensive in that interview, but it's kind of hard not to be, right?
Like if she's speaking her truth, it's traumatic.
Yeah, absolutely.
Like she has nobody to talk to. She wants to call her mom. Her mom has passed. Like, who did she talk to? She can't trust new people.
Yeah.
All right, well, that is your rumor report.
All right, thank you, Missy. Charlamagne, who you giving that donkey to?
Oh, man, 4 after the hour, I need a young woman named Talita Collier of Winter Haven, Florida, to come to the front of the congregation. She is just one of these adults out here that just love to be lying for lying's sake. Okay? Some people just love the lie.
I'm going to put her on Twitter then. All right, we'll get to it next. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning.
The Breakfast Club. Your mornings will never be the same.
Peace to the planet. This is Charlamagne Tha God, and it's NFT Tuesday, and the second Breakfast Club NFT collection is almost ready to drop. Drop one sold out. Drop two is going to be even better, so don't wait. Head over to oneof.com for more info on The Breakfast Club NFT.
Make sure you tell them to watch out for Florida, man.
Florida, man.
The craziest people in America come from the Bronx and all of Florida. Yes, you are a donkey.
A Florida man attacked an ATM for a very strange reason. It gave him too much money. Florida man is arrested after deputies say he rigged the door to his home in an attempt to electrocute his pregnant wife. Police arrested an Orlando man for attacking a flamingo.
The Breakfast Club, bitchy.
Donkey of the day. With Charlamagne Tha God. I don't know why y'all keep letting him get y'all like this.
Well, donkey of the day for Tuesday, April 26th. Let me make sure the day is 26th. Yes, Tuesday, April 26th goes to 34-year-old Talita Collier of Winter Haven, Florida. What does your Uncle Charla always tell you about the great state of Florida? The craziest people in America come from the Bronx and all of Florida. I spent the whole last week in Orlando last week. Drop on the clues bombs for Orlando. Everybody at our station out there, 104.5 The Beat. Beautiful, beautiful place Orlando is. And when you're down there feeling that Florida sun, you realize God really does favor babies and fools. Because God's favor is all over that fool upstate called Florida. Now, one thing I would never understand, though, in any state, is adults that lie. Okay, we grown, man. All right, you have no reason to be telling me a fib. Like, what do adults that lie think is going to happen to them when they tell the truth? Okay, well, Talita Collier didn't get that memo because she was late for work. And trust me when I tell you, working up here at the Breakfast Club for the past 12 years, I have heard some amazing excuses as to why people missed work. Okay, and this one is a great one. Can anyone in this room vouch for some of the great excuses we've heard as to why people are late?
They got arrested.
Show up? Oh, man. Oh, that was a great one.
That was
number
one.
The cat ate the wire under your laptop.
Oh, amazing.
Oh, that was enough. I forgot that one.
And these are people that I love, by the way. Okay, I got arrested, but they didn't put me in handcuffs. They just sat me in the back of the car.
Sat me in the back of the car
and drove me to the police station. Now, when you're a black man in America, especially a black man who's been arrested and been in handcuffs for nothing, you know that's not true, okay? The cat locked me in my bedroom. That was a good one.
Locked me in the bathroom.
Locked me in the bathroom. Locked me in my bathroom.
I got a fight on the train.
No, that was real. Oh. That was real. Dropping the clues bomb. These people that I love, who shall remain nameless.
Yeah,
all right.
Pretty much.
These are things that we actually heard. So we've heard some wild stories on why people didn't make it to work. And Talita Collier is added to that list this morning because according to Tampa 12 News, Talita was going to be late for work. So she told the sheriff's office, she actually made up a story about confronting a burglar, okay? Only armed with a knife, all right? Talita saw somebody trying to break into a car belonging to her parents, and she told her supervisor at work that she drew her agency-issued weapon and pointed it at the burglar who took off. I didn't know TSA had knives on them, okay? Well, her supervisor didn't believe her. You know how I know her supervisor didn't believe her? Because the sheriff's office said the TSA asked Collier for a case number and the name of the detective on the case. Talita couldn't provide either. So her supervisor told her to get a copy of the incident report. This is how you know her supervisor didn't believe her. She wanted all this information because she didn't believe her. And Talita doubled down on the lie because she sent several unreadable screenshots of the report to her supervisor. So then her supervisor said, well, I'm going to need a paper copy, which Talita never provided. See, this is her supervisor giving her the opportunity to come clean, okay? When that person came in here and told us that they got arrested and the cop put them in the back of the car but didn't handcuff them and drove them down just to use the phone, I said, let me tell you something, man. I don't know who you about to tell that lie to, but you need to rethink that one. That's what I would have told Talita in that situation, okay? But Talita just kept digging that hole deeper and deeper like a devil damn mole, okay? Now, investigators with the sheriff's office reviewed the images from Talita and determined them to be faker than DJ Envy's beard.
Stop
okay,
it.
And Collier, according to investigators, also used the name of a deputy who happened to be on vacation out of the country at the time of the incident. How did she know that? Okay, her parents also told investigators, I don't know what she's talking about. All right, they had no idea about the burglary report or that someone allegedly tried to break into their car. This is Sheriff Grady said, he said, I don't understand why anyone would go to the extent of creating a fake police report to avoid reprimand at work for tardiness. Sheriff Grady, have you met people? Okay. Now, Talita was already on an employee improvement plan for being late to work. So she clearly had been late to work multiple times. So they put her on this employee improvement plan. So that's probably why she reacted like this, because she thought she was going to lose her job. But now she has a charge of criminal use of a personal ID and uttering a false instrument. And now we can't believe anything she says ever again, because when you tell a lie once, all your truths become questionable. Okay, the truth doesn't cost you anything, but a lie can cost you everything. And Talita Collier of Winter Haven, Florida, clearly at this moment has lost everything. Please give Talita Collier of Winter Haven, Florida the biggest hee-haw. Now, would you like to? Let's play a game of Guess What Race It Is! Talita Collier of Winter Haven, Florida was already on an employee improvement plan for being late to work, was late on this day, woke up and said that she saw a burglar breaking into her parents' car, so she defended him with her agency-issued knife. Guess what race she is! Angela Yee?
Man, I don't want to say it.
What do you think?
Well, just off the fact that we were talking about a lot of excuses that we've heard, and our own experiences with people lying. I was talking to someone yesterday who was just telling me, man, I just be late to work all the time. I don't even care.
So are you saying this sounds like a nigga-generated excuse? Is that what you're telling us this morning?
Potentially, or maybe mixed.
You got to pick one, ye.
Yeah, what part? What part?
Why can't someone be mixed?
Because we don't have an interracial drop.
Okay. Well, then you're black.
All right. DJ Envy, yes. Talita Collier of Winter Haven, Florida, was already on employee improvement plan for being late to work. On this day that she was going to be late again, she decided to say that she saw a burglar breaking into her parents' car. So she defended him, defended the car, and waved the burglar off with a state agency-issued knife. Guess what race she is?
I got to go black.
Damn.
It's messed up.
Why?
Why don't we have an interracial drop?
Because it's the people that I work with, right? So if I look at it, right,
I'm thinking biracial drop.
The white people up here that work for the Breakfast Club, they're never late. But then I look.
Come on, don't do that. That's not true. That's not true.
Nick, you late?
Don't do that. Now see, you always got to jump out the window.
Nah, when Dan was never late.
I don't believe
you're always late.
What are you saying?
What about me?
You're black.
What about me?
Wow. Wow.
I don't be late.
You be late half the time.
No, I don't.
You're interracial.
I'm never late.
You're definitely late half the time. You're late half the time.
Yeah, so don't make me start filming y'all coming in here after me every day.
Well, guess what? I don't make no excuses. All right? Okay? I'm just late because I be late. All right? I'm old. All right?
What does that got to do?
The moral of the story is both of y'all are correct. Talita Collier is absolutely black. Okay?
That excuse.
This is a nigga generated excuse.
Yeah, it was. I didn't want to say it like that, but it kind of is.
I don't even want to say she's black.
We're really good at
this. This is 100% pure nigga.
Yeah.
Telling stories too. Like, you can't just tell a simple lie.
That's the other thing. That's how you know this is one of us. A lot of sauce was on this story.
But when you're late, sometimes you gotta tell sauce so you feel like.
No, the best thing to do if you're gonna lie about something is to keep it simple.
No,
that's
like,
true.
The dude that said he was arrested, he would have probably been all right. But Charlamagne said, if I was you, I would go in there and tell the truth.
I told him not because it sounded stupid.
You gotta keep it simple. That's all.
Then he went in there and told him.
All you gotta do is say, I wasn't feeling good. That's it. Nobody could question
that. I had my period.
I believe you.
True.
Envy.
True.
Let's use that as a drop.
Let's use that one.
I'm definitely that. Using that one.
Please keep that.
I'm using that one at some point in life.
But you had your
guess
period?
What, Envy? That's not a period. And that blood is for a different reason.
I dare you to tell me I don't have one. You don't know what I identify as.
You're right.
Okay?
Okay.
All right. Well, then.
It's got a little awkward. All right. Well, let's open up the phone line. 800. Why are you looking at me like that?
Up the phone lines, man. We already late. Do niggas be lying?
What would a biracial drop sound like?
Niggas be lying. 800-585-1051. Do people be lying?
You know adults that just be lying.
They be lying for no reason.
No reason.
800-585-1051. Well, let's talk about it. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning.
The Breakfast Club.
It's topic time. Call 800-585-1051 to join into the discussion with The Breakfast Club.
Talk about it.
Morning, everybody. It's DJ Envy, Angela Yee, Charlamagne Tha God. We are The Breakfast Club. Now, if you just join us, it's coming out of Charlamagne's Donkey of the Day. Now, you gave Donkey the Day to who?
Man, I gave Donkey the Day to a young lady named Talita Collier of Winter Haven, Florida. She was late for work. She was already on an employee improvement plan for being late to work, and she was going to be late again on this day, so she decided to tell her supervisor that her parents' car was being burglarized, and so she went and approached the burglar with her state agency issued knife, and that's why she was late. But this never happened.
My goodness.
This never happened.
So we're asking 800-585-1051, do you know an adult liar that lies all the time?
Just adults that just be lying for no reason. And by the way, I don't understand what's the point of being an adult who lies. Because what do you think is going to happen to you?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, this woman right here was lying to keep her job, but now the lie cost her job. Mm. So why not just tell the truth?
Correct. So, Yee, do you know an adult liar?
Yeah, I do.
You still speak to the person?
I know a couple of people. Not so much. But I do know somebody that like randomly tells lies all the time, and then they always get caught because they tell different lies to different people. Mm-hmm. And then by the time it gets back to you, and then we sit around and be like, she told you this? Yeah, she told me that. Well, that's not what she told me. She said the opposite. So we all just kind of like know what it is.
That's why they always say, you know, it's better to tell the truth, because when you tell the truth, you don't got to remember what you say.
Yeah, you don't remember the lie. Yeah, I know one I'm not friends with the person anymore. And I try to make sure that if any lies, I try to keep out of my circle. But the person was lying, but it could have been detrimental to me. Like, he was lying to people that could have got me hurt.
Okay. Yeah.
And when that happens, I know that you don't care about me. You don't care about my family.
Yeah, it's like malicious intent.
Yeah, definitely malicious intent. But he was lying to make himself look good, but it would have possibly got me in trouble or got me into a situation where I could have got hurt. So I don't deal with lies. If you lie, I just, you know, no disrespect, just get the hell away from me.
And by the way, exaggerating is lying, mm-hmm. by the way. And I don't understand adults that volunteer the lie to you, especially when when people call you and tell you something and then you find out they were lying and you was like, why? You didn't even have to tell me what you told me. I didn't even ask you. It had nothing to do with me, wasn't pertaining to me. You just decided to call me and lie for what? That's sick.
All right, well, let's go to the phone lines. Hello, who's this?
DJ Hadouken, residing out of Atlanta, man. DJ Hadouken, like street body.
Hadouken, what's up, brother?
Not much, nah, but I agree, man. We be lying. We be lying. I keep I had to tell my job, I was like, man, my mama, she's sick. I gotta drive back to Oklahoma, and because I'm from Tulsa, I gotta drive back to Oklahoma and make sure she's good, and she gotta make sure she's in the hospital. Boy, I had to go to New York the next day to go to Rock Nation to play these beats, bro.
So hold on, were you telling, you went to Rock Nation to play beats?
Yeah.
Now your phone's lying on you.
Oh, there we go.
Okay.
Yeah, so I had to go to New York, you know, get these producers and stuff going on. But when I went back home, they was like, how was your mother? Is everything okay? Yeah, she's good. She, you know.
Let me ask you a question.
And everything.
Did you get any beat placements?
Yeah. We got a little something going on real soon.
Lie.
That's a lie. That was a lie.
When a nigga tell you that they got a little something going on real soon, that's a lie.
Yeah, that's a lie.
That's a lie. You're wishful thinking. You're being hopeful. You're trying to speak things into existence, but you're lying.
Nah, I'm not playing at all.
Okay, what time? When y'all connected with Jay-Z?
I wasn't coming to get connected with Jay-Z.
He was going to Rock Nation. Maybe he went to see the A&Rs.
Okay.
Yeah, they run through A&R, so I didn't know. I wasn't coming up for Jay-Z. I was just trying to get a chance with anything.
Like who? Who'd you see?
What's the A&R?
Fabio Foreign was there at the time, so it was really Fabio Foreign. But when I was at the producer camp, it was like a lot of drill. It just threw me off because I'm like, my sound sounds like Pharrell. I'm not here to. Everybody, their mama had a drill beat. Like now, I was just like, what
now
the
you
world?
Sound like Pharrell? That's a lie.
So exactly. So what do you think you got going on? I just want to know. What
I
do you think?
I use Ableton.
I don't know who that is. Who is Ableton?
If you're a producer, you know what that is. If you're a producer, you know what that is.
Charlamagne is not a producer,
okay.
Sir.
All right. Well, I wish you the best, sir.
You're lying to him. Why are you lying to him? You don't wish him the best. You don't really wish him the best. 800-585-1051. Do you know an adult liar? Let's talk about it. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning. I know when
Call me.
Add your opinion to The Breakfast Club topic.
Come on.
800-585-1051.
Morning, everybody. It's DJ Envy, Angela Yee, Charlamagne Tha God. We are The Breakfast Club. Now, if you just joined us, we're asking, do you know an adult liar?
Yes, f***ers be lying, right? For no reason. Go to the phone.
Hello, who's this?
Hey, this is T from Toledo. How y'all doing?
Hey, T from Toledo. They tell me that you a big liar in Toledo.
Not me. I try to keep it real. That's why I ain't got no friends.
All right. Now tell us about this adult liar.
Well, my cousin, probably maybe about a couple of months ago, she started saying that this dude that she supposedly go with is buying her a house. Supposedly he bought this $300,000 house. She done sent pictures and everything else. But in all actuality, a whole nother married couple done bought the house. She's talking about she got keys and she don't want to spend $4,000 on furniture, refurnishing the house. Then she could move in because something wasn't up to code. And then turn around, like after she told me she spent the money on the furniture, turned around and asked me to borrow some money. And the crazy part is this dude don't even have a car. Like, I don't know how he buying a $300,000 house.
Yeah, what's going to happen like when these lies catch up? I think it's so funny when people lie to you and you know they're lying and you just let them keep going.
Yes. But I had to call. You say what?
Yeah, I don't understand why she would lie like that and then when there was a whole other couple that got the house. I don't get it.
Yeah, a whole other couple. And I started calling her out on it because it kept going on. And she was like, well, it's something that we doing different with real estate, and you don't understand. I spent $1,500 to take a class so I could learn this, and I can't explain it to you because you small-minded.
Man, he hit you with a lot. Listen, a nigga love to tell you that you don't understand when he lying. And they loved it. And they love to tell you that you small minded when they lying.
Thank you, Mama. Hello, who's this?
Good morning. It's Victoria.
Hey, Victoria.
Hey, Victoria. Or Toya. You said Toya or Victoria?
It's actually Victoria government wise, but I go by Toya.
Okay.
All right, Toya. So let's talk about it. You know an adult liar or you one?
I have been one. I mean, come on, man. It's Tampa, Florida. This is what we do. We drive to the courthouse, no license or
goodness. Ticket.
So what you be lying about?
Now lying to law enforcement don't count.
Actually, I wanted to get out of a ticket. I had got pulled over. I know my license was funky, so I faked the label.
You faked the label?
Yes, I did.
How the hell do you fake a whole label?
Were you pregnant? Yeah.
No, I wasn't.
Oh, so that stomach came in handy, huh?
Yes, it did. They escorted me, though, the whole interstate ride when I got there. But come on now, they're not going to sit there and actually do the paperwork. So I had to wait like 15 minutes, and then I drove off from TDA.
Now, how many months do you usually look on a regular basis when you're just walking around?
Slim. When I tell you, Charlamagne, all right. I don't know how I pulled that
off. So how you fake labor then if you slim?
I don't know. I have no idea. He just must have been simple. It's Florida, man.
You sure you don't look like a lowercase B?
No, oh, man.
Oh, no, absolutely not. You can check that resume. It's
okay.
Fact. I'm like a buck 35.3.
You could be lying.
Well, congratulations. Lying. Congratulations, man.
Thank you.
You the type
thank
to
you. And I just want to say, DJ Envy, I love you. Charlamagne, you are amazing. Like, for real. And
thank you, Queen.
Like, you awesome as well. Absolutely.
So one more thing. If you fake the pregnancy, you definitely fake the orgasm, huh?
I'm a mother of twins, so you feel me? I guess.
I don't know if we're amazing. She could be lying.
What did she say? She definitely could be lying, but she called them amazing.
I am.
That's a lie.
You got great taste.
Thank you, Mama. What's the moral of the story?
The moral of the story is, if you there's no need to be lying about things. The truth doesn't cost you anything, but a lie can cost you everything. Okay? Maybe, I don't know, maybe there is a time and place to lie. I don't know. I just don't understand why adults be lying to other adults for no reason. I understand her with the ticket. That's a little different.
Yeah, you know I would lie saying? In that situation, too.
But all just right. When people just randomly volunteer information to you just because they're trying to mess with your reality, I don't understand that.
Envy, next time you get pulled over, say you're pregnant.
I'll try it. All right, we got rumors on the way.
You can be pregnant.
Yes, let's talk about Kanye West. He had a house for sale, and Selling Sunset to Jason Oppenheim talks about what was on the ceiling that was a little strange.
All right, we'll get into that next. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning.
The Breakfast Club.
Listen up.
It's just in.
All the gossip. The rumor report. With Angela Yee.
It's The Rumor Report.
The Breakfast Club.
Well, on a recent episode of Netflix's Selling Sunset, Jason Oppenheim talks about revealing what a client once said about a home that Kanye West had lived in. And he said he didn't let the potential buyer know whose home it was.
You showed him Kanye West's house, right?
That was him. This is funny because we're not only did I show him Kanye's house, we get into escrow on Kanye's house. We didn't say who it was. Jeff invited his mom, and his mom, not knowing whose house it was, says, "It looks like a lonely narcissist lives here." And Jeff canceled the escrow.
I love my mother-in-law.
Well, there was a painting of Kanye, like as Jesus on the ceiling, like pointing. The shower was like a goldfish tank. It was.
Yeah, so.
Is that a selling point for people when you're like, oh, such and such used to live here?
Well, maybe not in this case.
For some people, I think it is.
Mm. But sometimes these real estate agents are told not to say whose house it is. A lot of times people don't want you to know. Because I know I went to go look at a house and it was like strict confidentiality on whose home it was that they were selling. Sometimes you could find out though. Anyway, I found out whose house it was.
But, whose house was it?
Kerry Washington.
Okay. So you just broke the confidentiality.
No, she didn't tell me. You could Google it and find out. That's how I found out.
Oh.
Yeah. So, but she never told us. She had a confidentiality with her. And then I later found out, you know, that's who owned the home. And I don't know if it was a flip for her or what her plans were for it. But yes.
But if there was a painting of Kanye as Jesus, I think people would know.
Yeah. On the ceiling.
On the ceiling.
In the bedroom.
In the bedroom, yeah. Kind of weird.
All right. Now, Future has revealed what his title and cover art for his new album is going to be. I Never Liked You.
I love it.
And then he's sitting in the backseat of the car with a eye mask on.
I love that title.
Never like
I love
you.
That yeah, you know, I salute to Dr. Rita Walker. She literally just posted this morning on Instagram, stop trying to be liked by everybody. You don't even like everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Not liking people is a form of self-care. Why do we got a front?
All right. Well, I Never Liked You is coming out on Friday, by the way, with guest appearances by Kanye West, Drake, Gunna, and more.
That sound like it is the levels of toxic on that album over them fire beats going to be phenomenal.
All right, and Gia and DJ Envy, a.k.a. Rashawn, when Gia's around, they did their press run, continued on yesterday, and you guys were on Tamron Hall. And here is Gia talking about the breakthrough in their marriage.
Gia, what do you see as the breakthrough moment?
When I was sitting in front of Tyrese and I said, you don't know Rashawn, you don't know me. Yeah. You don't even know if this relationship was worth saving. But you put yourself out of the way. Why? And when his words matched Rashid's words... It was so strong and powerful in that moment. I put my hands up and I began to tear, and I'm not a big crier. And I said, okay. I turned to him and I said, I forgive you. I don't know what that looks like. And I said, I will work on this, whatever God has intended for us. I don't know how long it's going to take. I don't know how it's going to go, but I will work on it until.
I don't like Tyrese getting all this credit for saving y'all relationships.
Why?
Simply because it's Tyrese. But you never know who God is going to use.
You never know what God's going to
say.
So
I'm not going to question it.
Mm-hmm.
All right. In addition, you guys were on with Trevor Noah.
Last night, yep.
Mm-hmm. And here's what Gia had to say about this cheating.
Rashawn didn't cheat on me. He cheated on himself.
Oh!
And a lot of women don't look at the situation that way when they're cheated on. And some men. But for me, it was very important to write the book because I want women to understand that men cheat, and it doesn't necessarily have to be because of you.
Huh.
It is because of them. So I didn't feel embarrassment. I own me, and I have to decide how I'm going to move forward with my head held high. It's very important for women to understand that.
Look at me, King.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't cheat on me. You cheated on yourself. That is a bar.
Yeah.
Okay? And she's absolutely right.
She is.
But
she is.
Since I didn't cheat on you, I cheated on myself. I forgive me. What's for dinner?
I forgive you. What's for dinner?
Right? You better not laugh.
Y'all gonna see Gia on some television, boy. Gia's,
you didn't
she's
cheat on me. You cheated on yourself. So who should I be apologizing to? That's real, though, because when you cheat on a great woman, you're really hurting yourself more than you're hurting her. You can't call yourself a real anything if you're lying to the person that you call your best friend, the person you spend more time with than anyone, the mother of your children. If you're lying to her, you ain't real at all. So, yes, you are really just cheating on yourself.
Absolutely.
God damn, that hurt me.
It did.
Every time Gia talk, I want to apologize to my wife, and I've been out here clean for 6 years.
All right, well, here is what else Envy had to say on Trevor Noah last night.
I don't want to hear from him.
Was there not a part of you that was worried that the DJ Envy would now basically be you know, losing himself to tell the truth?
I think these are the conversations we need to have. If you think about it, we can go to the barbershop and we talk about our favorite NBA player. We can talk about our favorite sneakers, our favorite music. But sometimes things that are important we need to discuss as well, and that is relationships. I wish I had somebody at the barbershop and say, hey, look, my wife is, me and her arguing about this.
Right.
Am I right? Is she right? What do I do? You know, how do we solve this conversation? Because at the end of the day, we're on the same team.
Right.
If we're arguing, we shouldn't be arguing to, I shouldn't be trying to annihilate her. She shouldn't be trying to destroy me in an argument. We should be trying to get to an understanding where we can both understand.
Now, I think those conversations were happening in the barbershop for a long time. The problem was all of us were doing a lot of the same things. And I think a lot of those conversations are still happening in the barbershop now. It's just that a lot of brothers are doing the work on themselves. A lot of brothers are healing themselves to show up to be the best, you know, men that we can for our women. So those conversations have evolved a lot.
They have evolved a lot.
Yes.
And they're starting to evolve even more. But, you know, some conversations like, you know, the orgasm thing. You can't go to the barbershop and say, like, hey, fellas, this, that, and the other.
Yes, you can.
All right, Charlamagne, can I? You in the barbershop, Charlamagne.
We've had this conversation before.
I'm going to show you some
recently,
video of
but
men
before,
in the barbershop.
We've been having this conversation
what?
Up here for years.
About what?
Me not orgasming.
You know what? Forget you. All right.
What
that
do
is
you
your
mean?
Rumor report. I hate you.
What are you talking
you
about?
Don't take things serious, man.
What
I be trying to be serious,
about?
And you don't take me serious.
I am being
That's
serious.
That's your problem.
I am being
no,
serious.
No, you don't take me serious.
Listen, we've been having this conversation, King. Okay? Let me come over and I'm going to smudge you.
No.
What are you going to
do?
This relationship that we have is over. Whatever you want to call it.
All right, guys.
Well,
that's your rumor
don't
report.
Play Bill.
Get ready for the
this
People's Choice Mix.
When you Whoa.
Over.
When you sign this Don't Play Gay bill, it'll be over.
What do you want to hear?
People's Choice
Mix
is up next. 800-585-1051 is the Breakfast Club. Good morning.
The Breakfast Club. Your mornings will never be the same.
Peace to the planet. This is Charlamagne Tha God, and it's NFT Tuesday, and the second Breakfast Club NFT collection is almost ready to drop. Drop one sold out. Drop two is going to be even better, so don't wait. Head over to oneof.com for more info on the Breakfast Club NFT.
WWPR-FM HD1 New York.
And iHeartRadio station.
Morning, everybody. It's DJ Envy, Angela Yee, Charlamagne Tha God. We are the Breakfast Club. Again, salute to Trevor Noah and the Daily Show staff and everybody for having me, and also Tierman Hall for having me. I appreciate you guys. Thank you so much for supporting my book. It means a lot, man. And like I said earlier this morning, the fact that, you know, we're still in the top 100 when it comes to books. And when I say that, that's a lot of books. So that's like children's
millions
books.
And millions
that's,
of books.
You know, diet books, cookbooks, and a whole bunch of more. So I just want to say salute to you guys for holding me down. We really appreciate it. All right. And when we come back, we got the positive note, so don't move. It's the Breakfast Club. Good morning. Morning, everybody. It's DJ Envy, Angela Yee, Charlamagne Tha God. We are the Breakfast Club. It's time to get up out of here.
That's right. And the positive note, man, is simply this. You can lie to anyone else in the world, but you can't lie to yourself. Please remember that. Remember it, please.
Breakfast Club, bitches!
Y'all finished or y'all done?